currently sitting on the standings. We can see it will be the Turbo Cleave locked in from XRB to the moon in the first game against Reformed.
Mistweaver Monk from Looney. We saw him showcase that at the summer finals earlier this year, and it almost got him to BlizzCon, so he's definitely a well-veteraned Mistweaver Monk, but mages love Mistweaver Monks. They get lots of crowd control. ZPI's going to have to back him up a lot to be able to survive this initial assault. Reformed get perfect crowd control initially. If XRB to the Moon are greedy in this position, it could cost them the match. ZPI's actually playing the Veiled Eye, trying to get some extra defense, really all focused in on that defense against Rogue Mage setups. I think it's a smart move by the teams in this tournament.
Yeah, Looney into crowd control, gets locked out as well, but ZPI is going to be full HP. Looney throwing out some heals now, incapacitate onto Relza. Nice cheap shot coming in from Flappers. That was very well done, denying the leg sweep coming in from Looney, breaking up that CC chain just a little bit. Looney gets, he actually gets polymorph there on his Aura Mastery, not able to fully top off ZPI, and unfortunately has to trade out the Life Cocoon as well. Reformed has lots of crowd control, lots of pressure very early on.
Yeah, at the moment, there's really no pressure on their side to try and reverse in favor. Reformed have everything in their control. ZPI pops Ascendance to try and get a miracle kill on Gelu, but he's already Frost Nova'd Blizzo. ZPI gets stunned away. Reformed take control of the match. This is the first time we've seen Gelu really utilized effectively in a series. We said Reformed were pigeonholed onto jungle, but their performance so far on this Rogue Mage Priest is really running XRB to the moon for a loop. ZPI trying to retreat away. Nice blink counterspell by Gelu. If they can force Astral Shift, but unfortunately not. Nice Hex on Gelu by ZPI. It stalls out a lot of damage. Good awareness there by him, seeing that his healer soaked the interrupt. He went for crowd control to stall it out. Now they make a swap to Relza, and I think tunneling the Disciplined Priest is the right move in this matchup.
Yeah, definitely not a bad strategy at all. Ring of Peace going to be used there by Looney to knock Relza out of his power ward barrier. So that was very nicely done to sort of get a little bit more pressure for his team. But Relza seems to be just fine in this situation. Now a little pressure over onto ZPI as Flappers and Gelu looking to get aggressive. But there's no crowd control on Looney. You can see, look at how he's positioned very far away. Gelu's going to have to overcommit. Relza's going to have to push in order to get a fear. Flappers going to have to commit the Shadow Step. And then ZPI can just run away. Gelu now going to be pushing for a full polymorph. Manages to land it with a kidney shot on ZPI. He could be in some trouble right now. Looney, no trinket available, but Blizzard's going to leap over and deny the follow-up polymorph coming in from Gelu.
All right, ZPI still in a 3-on-1, but he tremored the psychic screen by Rels. A nice move from ZPI, getting Looney out of crowd control. These hexes on Gelu are also very annoying. I like that ZPI is effectively using that crowd control. Mages gain D-Curse back in Battle for Azeroth, so he can dispel hex off his partners, but he can't off himself. That's just 8 seconds of time where Gelu can't develop momentum. They catch Relza in a stun. I really think he is ultimately the kill target. As soon as they've stabilized, they feel safe. They should make switches to the Priest and try and push him over the edge. In the meantime, we see Stormbolt on Gelu trying to slow down the polymorphs on Looney as Looney is securing the mana advantage. It's obvious that XRB to the Moon are playing for the long game with ZPI running those tank trinkets and Looney just playing so defensively in the back line. XRB to the Moon playing to their strengths. It's up to Reform to find an opportunity to win before the clock is run out.
And normally the Mistweaver Monk, you see them run that Way of the Crane, which provides a little bit of extra damage and a lot of bonus healing, but Looney's opting not even to run that. So you can see just how defensive XRB really wants to run. They know that Reformed is on a timer, essentially. Relza, once he runs out of mana, there's no way he can sustain his team through the Enhancement Shaman and Arms Warrior damage. So XRB, they're just playing a waiting game. They just need to stall it out a little bit longer. ZPI playing very defensively. Nice Ring of Peace, going to be denying a fear, and Looney's been doing a good job making sure he's always moving away from Relza, so he's not susceptible to those fears.
Flappers are smart. They're not overextending that Rop would have line of sighted Relza, so Flappers just waited a second, allowing Relza to get in line of sight, but that clock is starting to run out. Relza almost completely out of mana. Flappers got ported on his Shadow Step stun, I think. Nice moves by Looney. Double Psychic Scream on the DPS, and this spells panic for the team of Reform. They're desperately trying to switch to Looney. He pre-life cocoons, but they've shredded through that. He actually doesn't have trinkets. ZPI needs to back him up. He's out of Maelstrom. He has to cast heals. Those are not going to be doing... it's just enough for Looney to escape to safety. I almost thought those casted heals were going to be an opening for XRB or for Reform to get a kill. Another swap to Looney could still be the game. Nice counterspell. That's going to put XRB behind.
Yeah, I really want to see Looney reposition his statue. It's on the other side of the map, really not giving him any additional healing. Gelu pushing in for a polymorph with a kidney shot over onto ZPI. He has his Ascendance up right now, so Reform could be in a little bit of trouble. Relza almost completely gassed out at this point of the game. Looney in a very safe position, just spamming out the Soothing Mist. Mistweavers are very susceptible to interrupts. All their healing can be interrupted for the most part, like we see right now. But once those interrupts are down, Mistweavers have some of the most effective healing in the game to top off their team.
Ooh, nice mind control at low health by Relza, trying to make it difficult for Looney to recover. They get a polymorph snuck in between. ZPI trinkets, he's on the run. Good intimidating shell by Blizzo. Stalls out Flappers. Reconnect. ZPI should survive. Nice Hex. These Hexes have been really MVP by ZPI. It just slows down the mage's pressure so much. And XRB to the moon are playing the stall tactic to burn down Rels' mana. Look at it. That blue bar below his health. It's almost completely tapped. Looney has a huge advantage there. Gelu gets swapped to. Trades Temporal Shield. They aren't able to race against it. That's going to pop him back up to full here quite shortly. They switch to ZPI with the blind. Looney was greedy and did not trinket blind. Very greedy move, but it looks like he's going to get away with it. Grounding Totem to deny the polymorphs. He gets a couple casted heals out, but now re-polymorphed. ZPI down at half. He's building up Maelstrom to try and trade up for healing surges. Looney actually trinkets, but gets counterspelled. Good crowd control by Reformed. But in the meantime, XRB and the Moon are also getting good stuns. It's a race to the finish. Relza has no mana. XRB to the moon have no cooldowns. It's still anyone's match, but it's going to be ending soon.
Gelu has been doing such an insane job in this game with just landing polymorph after polymorph on Looney, immediately locking him out, and that's really where the pressure for Reformed is coming from. So excellently done by him, but unfortunately, ZPI, he's able to keep himself alive. Looney's able to top him off out of those crowd control chains. You can see Gelu wants to get aggressive. He uses the ice form. A lot of pressure over on ZPI right now as they make a huge swap onto him. Full polymorph on Looney. No trinket available. ZPI, how are you going to survive this one? An astral shift gets popped out immediately as soon as it's off cooldown. He needs to survive a little longer. Relza with the double fear. Blizzo trying to come and help, but Looney still into the polymorphs. ZPI barely escaping here. Looney has the life cocoon, needs to connect it, and ultimately does. That could have been the final push for Reformed as Relza has no mana left.
No mana, and Flappers doesn't have evasion. The next Stormbolt on Flappers, he's gonna flop. Like, even Relza is in trouble. They're tunneling him down. It's a race to the finish. Nice leg sweep. Relza has no trinket, but ZPI can't connect. Blizzo needs to solo the kill. He doesn't have enough damage. He's gonna Stormbolt Flappers and switch, but ZPI's not connected. He's caught by that frozen orb, and he's actually retreating away. That Stormbolt was their kill condition, and ZPI doesn't want to go for the kill. He's just gonna play for an even longer match, but this is leaving an opening for Reformed. Even though they're tapped, they've got Looney locked in polys. The kidney shot ZPI. He chooses not to trinket. They've still got him in a 3v2. I'm not sure if ZPI can heal through this deep into dampening. He goes for the double sundering, buys a couple more seconds, but he's overcommitted on defense. Looney connects a heal. Will that be enough? The Aura Mastery is the potential counterspell. Spams out a huge surge miss and saves the day. There's the Stormbolt for the win. ZPI connects. Relza life grips Flappers to safety. ZPI goes for another Hex. Pops Ascendance. He can attack from range and try and take Flappers down. I don't know how Relza is doing this, man. He's completely tapped. He's hanging on by a thread.
I don't think he can hold out much longer with this Ascendance, though. That's going to be the final nail in the coffin. XRB manages to hold on just long enough, but honestly, that's the best I've seen Reformed run that Rogue Mage pre-setup, and I, like I said, I'm very impressed with Gelu in this matchup.
I feel like that's the story of XRB, though. OG composition on the jungle cave.
Looney playing Way of the Crane now. Way of the Crane is basically an all-in talent now for Mistweaver, and I was wondering if they're going to just run at the Priest of Way of the Crane, but you're susceptible to crowd control because you have to run in and punch people, so not playing, that means you can play far back and play for a longer match. Mistweaver mana is in a much better position, and with this composition, it makes sense for Looney to focus on defense. It's interesting that he's playing at the tombstones on the side of the map. We almost never see teams play in this position, and I'm curious to see how it plays out. XRB is stacked up together, but he's taking so much damage early on, Ben. Looney's trying to recover. ZPI hangs on by a thread throughout this initial assault, but now a freezing trap. ZPI in a 3-on-2. He's just trying to kite behind the pillar. Looney has to trinket, and Reformed just dominate in the first couple seconds of this game.
XRB to the moon has used literally every single defensive that they have. Looney has to escape. He needs to avoid a little bit more follow-up crowd control. ZPI still not topped off, though. Looney gets interrupted. ZPI's in a lot of trouble. He's going to have to keep himself alive. Flappers chasing him down, though. Relza as well. You can see his mana. He has just spammed a spell that's developing this. Looney gets caught into an interrupt, into a maim. Relza trying to get in position for a fear. If he can land the full trap right now, ZPI will ultimately go down. Doesn't even matter. And those are the bites from Flappers we just know and love, and Reformed will tie up the series.
Reformed, we missed you in Cup 1. What an absolutely explosive performance from Flappers, the king of the bite, the king of the jungle.
They need to stop Relza from getting on top of Looney. Very, very important that he's not eating those fears. Although ZPI has the tremor, like we kind of talked about, Reformed has been so good with the cross crowd control, it's difficult for him to get that off.
ZPI dropped grounding, but he didn't pick up Ethereal. He may be running triple damage on her talents, which could be an all-in on Relza. It looks like they're just leg sweeping Flappers and going after him in the room. Relza's pushing forward. This is a triple cleave. This is a nice move by Blizzo. He got a ton of pressure there on all... What is happening right now to Relza? He trade. What is this? What? What? What?
That
That has to be triple honor talents from ZPie for damage. I don't think anything else could create that much pressure.
XRB came into this game with a plan.
Which is just super effective against teams that all in you. It makes your regrowth instant. It boosts all of your healing. You just mash out that regrowth button and get tons of big crits.
Yeah, we'll have to see if Reformed looks for an all-in strategy. I think it's likely, knowing that they're Reformed, they're playing the Dark Archangel. Looney just sitting in stealth for now. Probably going to be throwing out an Iron Bark very early on. Doesn't want to fall behind. ZPie looking to put some pressure out on Dizio. And still, Looney just... still now just getting out of stealth. Flapper's going to open up. He's going to be moving forward for a bash on the Looney. Manages to find it, but Looney pre-Ironbarks this go. ZPie should be able to survive.
Yeah, with the heal over time effects and the Ironbark preemptively used there by Looney, ZPie should be able to survive, but they still have Freezing Trap. If Flappers can reconnect, he uses Stampede to boost his movement speed. He gets back on target with 1 more second left on that Freezing Trap. A Swift Man connects. Looney does not want to use Tree of Life until Flappers pulls the trigger. That's the Incarn. There's the Tree of Life. One for one exchange by Looney. This should allow them to easily survive the opening burst. And look at the mana already for Relza. He's in trouble.
Yeah, Relza's in a lot of trouble. Caught into the Stormbolt. Has his Pain Suppression. Has his Trinket. Doesn't want to trade it out too late. Looney caught into the Maim, though. Can Relza get there for a Fear? Doesn't look like it. Blizzard just snaring him up. Discipline Priest just doesn't have that much mobility. Dizio looking for the full trap. Doesn't manage to find it on the Looney. And Looney easily keeps ZPie alive for now. He still has that Astral Shift he can hold on to. Relza almost tapped on mana at this point in the game. There's a stun onto ZPie. Powered Barrier going to keep Relza alive for a little bit longer. But this is looking really good for XRB.
They survived the all-in. They're looking to kite for this Freezing Trap. Dizio not even going for it at this point. Looney jumps in, bashes Flappers, and gets in the line of sight of ZPie. That was a cheeky wild charge play by Looney. I don't really like this innervate outside of Tree of Life. I think it would have been much wiser to use it during it. He spent a lot of mana in Tree of Life. Unfortunately for Relza, he's still behind and he's still getting tunneled down. Relza's on a clock. He's got almost nothing left. He gets pummeled on the heel, gets winchered on the follow-up. Nice interrupt chain by XRB to the moon. Relza's on the ropes. He goes for a Fear, but he gets feared himself. He's still dangerously low, trying to get out of Shadow Man, but he's got no mana left, and this is likely to be it for Reformed. XRB, there's no openings right now for Reformed. They've got all the momentum. Relza has got nothing. Multiple interrupts headed his way. Stormbolt connects. XRB to the moon. Make it look easy in game number four, advancing 3-1.
Oh, ZPie did such a solid defense there for Looney. He was always dropping that grounding totem. You could
speed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.